Let's go over the difference between the different versions of the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines. And most people are concerned with conformance level AA, so we will keep it there. So with the different versions, we're primarily looking at 2.0, 2.1, and the just recently published 2.2. So we have these different versions of WCAG. And what's important to know is that they're comprised of success criteria. And think of the success criteria as things to do for accessibility. So there are all these different requirements to be in conformance with these technical standards. And so each version has a different number of success criteria. And when it comes to version 2.0 AA, there are 38 things to do. So again, 38 is what I have on the whiteboard. And we just need to account for those to be conformant with WCAG 2.0 AA. And then when it comes to version 2.1, what happened is we added 12 additional success criteria. So I think this is really important. Nothing has been undone in the previous version. All that has happened is we've added additional success criteria to it. So we didn't change the wording, nothing else happened. We've just added to the previous version of the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines. So with version 2.1, we have 12 additional success criteria. And what's important to keep in mind is that WCAG is mostly backwards compatible. And the only reason I say mostly is because in 2.2, we saw just 6 additional success criteria added, but they took away one general success criterion. And so it landed us at 55 success criteria. So they broke their own backwards compatible rule. And when I say backwards compatible, I mean that nothing is undone in the previous versions. But in this case, with 2.2, they did remove one of the more general success criterion. But that said, we're still basically just adding 6 additional things to do. So that's the difference. And when you are procuring an audit, it's important to know that, okay, we can get 2.0 and we can get 2.1, but is the additional cost for 2.1 that much more? Likely not. And the reason is because the industry standard has become 2.1 AA. So the price is probably going to be the same. Now, if you just want 2.0, or if maybe you're getting a VPAT and you're only concerned with 2.0 because maybe you're looking for compliance with the AODA, maybe you're looking for compliance with Section 508, those laws have incorporated 2.0. So you might think, well, I don't want anything to do with 2.1. Just know that 2.1 is only going to make your accessibility more robust. And so there will be more work to do, right? When we get that audit, additional accessibility considerations will be taken into account. So there will be potentially more work to do, but you are going to have a more extensive audit and it is going to help the accessibility of your website or other digital assets. So this is the difference with 2.0, 2.1, and even 2.2. What's important to keep in mind is that we're mostly just adding additional things to do. Nothing is being undone. So these aren't radically different versions of these technical standards. It's only that we're making the standards have additional requirements for conformance. So 2.0 is what I call the classic standard. 2.1 is really what I consider best practice. And then 2.2 is this newer version that, yes, it would be great if we can get here, but let's make sure to get to 2.1 first. So how you approach this depends, but now you're aware of the different versions of the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines. And if you need help with an audit or remediation at accessible.org, we can take care of everything for you. Also, if you would like training on the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, my course, the WCAG course, can help you learn these different success criteria that comprise all of the versions of the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines. So the course actually has modules for 2.0, 2.1, and 2.2 so that you can approach the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines with whatever version you're concerned with first and then work from that. And so that training is available at wcagcourse.com. And I will include links to these resources in the description.